So today I'm going to share with you one tip that really saved my time on changing colors on Illustrator. I remember before knowing this tip, I was actually physically changing color of my artworks again and again, and it used to take a lot of time for me. But this one tip is going to be super quick. Just imagine. So there are two parts to it. The first part is we're going to create our own color palette on Illustrator. And then the second part is being able to change colorways of a print or anything. So now here, as you see, I'm just going to refer to any one of the mood boards for now. But the main idea is to share with you the trick on Illustrator. So I'm just searching for a mood board, a fashion mood board on SS23, and I'll just pick up, I think I like this color palette. I'll just copy this on Illustrator. And yeah. So I bring it here on Illustrator. So the first thing that we need to do is, actually there are two ways, but I'm not going to stress on that. All I'm going to do is create some boxes. So, and I'm going to Command D, and it's copied all these different boxes. Now, just to have them visible, I'll just keep them with the default fill and stroke. So now, quickly, what I'll run is I'll press I for the eyedropper and start picking up colors, and V for the black arrow. So this is how I'll pick up colors from the mood board itself, and look how I build up my own color palette. You can do the same with your own original mood board. You don't have to really refer to somebody else's mood board, but definitely this is just a trick that I want to share with you. So I like all these colors, whatever's building up, and also let's take one skin color. So let's understand that this is our color palette. I can remove this now. This is my color palette. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to take this down to swatches. And as you see this box, I'm going to expand it a little bit for you to see. All I'm going to do is keep them selected and press this new color group. I'll create this as SS23, or you can name it anything with selected artwork, because this is where all the colors are there. So there you go. So I said okay, and the colors are here in. Now this is set as a color palette. Now part two is having a print. So first of all, let me just quickly create a print. So I'm going to take this inspiration from Ensel Taylor's print, which I got from WGSN. This is just for reference. I'm not really going to copy it, but I love the entire feel of it. It's very colorful. It has that very tropical kind of a feel to it. So yeah, lovely inspiration. Definitely, I'm just going to create a quick print out of it. So let's just quickly get on the time lapse. If I have to create a new color palette for this one and I want these colors to be implemented here, I cannot just go on selecting each and every this thing and keep watching if they are going to be nice or not. But on the other hand, there's a shortcut to it. And what you have to do is just select the artwork, go to Edit, Edit Colors, Recolor Artwork, and within this entire box, you can even go to Advanced Options. There you go. As if you remember, we had created a color palette out of it, which is Spring Summer 23, SS23. I'm going to click on this. Boom. Let's see. See that. So it's all in this color palette. Now, the next thing is if you like this color, just say OK and make another copy. And again, try Edit, Edit Colors, Recolor Artwork, go to Advanced Option and click on this. You'll have randomly changed color order. So now if you keep clicking, you'll get different options. You can even see the background changing to another color palette, I mean to another color combination. You like it, you say okay, and go to Edit, Edit Colors, Recolor Artwork, and Advanced Options. And then, yeah, just keep exploring that. How cool is that, right?
So yes, here we learned on Illustrator about how to create a color palette, a customized color palette, and the second part is about how to change into that color palette combination. That was the quick tip that I wanted to share in this video, and if you really like this video and if you learned something new, let me know. I love to know on the comment section below, and if you really felt that you learned something, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you're notified about all the new videos. And with that, I want you also to check out my previous 2-Minute Tuesday video, which is about photography on smartphone. Please go and check that video out. And with that, I'll see you next Tuesday.